Charlie's wife ended up pregnant, and she delivered a baby girl. Their baby girl only lived about 20 minutes after birth. That morning of October 2nd, Charlie said goodbye to his own two children at the bus stop, and then drove the smoke truck out to the Nickelmine schoolhouse. Usually on an average day, there's only one adult there, and it's the teacher, but that day there were four, including the teacher. The teacher, her mother, her sister, and her one sister-in-law. One of them was pregnant, and when Charlie walked in the schoolhouse with his guns, the one sister-in-law was trying to comfort a seven-year-old named Naomi Rose. Charlie told all the adults to leave, and the teacher and one of her sister-in-laws ran to the nearest neighbor's house to call for help. After the adults left, the boys were then ordered to get out, and they all crowded around the outhouse, not knowing what was happening next. They all prayed. Charlie and all the girls that were left in the schoolhouse lay in front of the blackboard while he tied their hands and their feet. The police got there, and he ordered them off the property to start to shoot. Charlie shot each one of the girls before he then shot himself. Marion, who we would later find out from the survivors, told Charlie to shoot her first. She died at the schoolhouse, and Naomi died in the state trooper's arms. So why did he do it? That was a question going through many of the parents and even the minds of the community. From an interview on LancasterPA.com, one of the girls had said, Charlie said, I am angry at God and I need to punish some Christian girls to get even with him. And he also said, I'm going to make you pay for my daughter, right before he shot them all. Four girls died that day and the rest were critically injured. This is close to home not only for the reason it was just 50 miles from my house, but for the fact that we knew one of the little girls in that schoolhouse that day. Their dad made furniture, and my family and him have gotten close through that business. His daughter did not die that day, but she was left in a vegetative state. So what is the problem? Why are all these school shootings happening? According to Axios.com, since the Columbine High School massacre set off a nationwide moral panic in 1999, there have been 10 school shootings in which four or more people were killed, including death or suicide by the perpetrators. These mass shootings have resulted in 122 fatalities. This problem is not only in Florida or in PA. There has been a school shooting in 10 different states that have claimed four people's lives. This problem is very widespread in the United States. Another problem, it is not just limited to college or high schools. People that young should not have to fear going to school in elementary schools, middle schools, schools, or even high schools. No student should ever have to fear like that. When these shootings happen, and like I said before, at least four people were killed, this causes grief on the family and the friends, community. This problem does not just affect the person who died, it affects their family and greatly the community they live in, and sometimes it doesn't even stop there. TheGuardian.com held an interview with one of the survivors' parents of the Florida school shooting, and the parents stated, "Not knowing if my daughter was alive at the time reminded me of 9/11. When I waited anxiously to hear if my brother, an NYPD sergeant, had survived the attack. As college students, some of us may not remember the feeling we had when the towers came down that day, since we were still pretty young. But having someone describe the feelings of terror just like 9/11 brings into perspective how serious the problem affects family and friends. If you ask my opinion, there is not one main thing that causes someone to do a school shooting. There are many different factors that can cause someone to bring themselves to do that. A few that I'm going to talk about are bullying, mental illness, and gun-free zones. On the survey I sent out to everyone, one of my questions was, what are some reasons you think people decide to do school shootings? Bullying and mental illness were the top two answers, with impulse right behind it. I agree that bullying and mental illness combined are the top reasons that drive people to do such a horrible thing. Newsweek.com said 71% of school shooters have felt persecuted, bullied, threatened, attacked, or injured, leading up to their rampage, and that bullied high schoolers are also more than twice as likely to bring guns or knives to schools than their non-bully peers. They also stated that a few shooters have even acknowledged bullying as their driving force behind the attack. Caleb Sharp, a 15-year-old who killed one student and injured three in Washington State, said he wanted to teach everyone a lesson about what happens when you bully others. If bullying pushes people to want to teach people a lesson, then why are there people who still do it? The next big reason is mental illness. LATimes.com stated at least 59% of the 185 public mass shootings that took place in the United States from 1900 through 2017 were carried out by people who had either been diagnosed with mental illness or showed signs of mental illness before the attack. Lastly, I wanted to touch on gun-free zones. When I think of gun-free zones, I think of people that are there that have no way to defend themselves. Schools are gun-free zones. People who do school shootings say that from the time they open fire until the cops get there, they can hurt vast amounts of people because there's no one to defend themselves. Most schools may have an officer there, but some officers should not carry a weapon, so again, there's no way to defend themselves. This statistic was taken from the Daily Wire, and it said, a According to the Crime Prevention Research, gun-free zones have been the target of more than 98% of all mass shootings, school shootings included. People who want to hurt other people will go to places where they know they can do mass amount of damage, and to them, what better place than a gun-free zone? So lastly, what can we do to solve this issue? In my survey, I asked, do you think schools should have a trained guard or guards? And 14 of the people that responded, 10 said yes, 2 said no, and 2 said maybe. I personally think that having someone trained in gun safety and also trained in how to recognize signs of a school shooter or in danger would help stop things faster. In Maryland, a trained school resource officer stopped a male with a handgun. CNN stated that Blaine Gaskill responded to the scene in less than a minute and fired around to stop the suspect. This is proof that armed guards or officers can prevent these things from happening or to stop them before people get injured. Other ways would be body search every student as they walk into school or at the same time have metal detectors that they have to go through before they can even enter the school. And in college settings, maybe even having the military students that are licensed and know how to handle a gun, they can carry it, none of the students would even know. No one should not want to go to school because they are being bullied so bad. Even at the state level, starting a no bullying campaign can really crack down on bullying schools. I feel like there are some solutions to lessen and hopefully stop this problem of school shootings. School shootings are a major problem in the U.S. today, and now that I have pointed out some causes and solutions, I challenge you to step up next time to see someone being bullied. I'm going to leave you with this. Imagine you are older and have children, and you send them off to school one day. You live pretty close to the school, and all of a sudden you hear police sirens and ambulances.